With Civil and Environmental Consultants Incorporated, and I'm here with my colleague ecologists, Marissa Logan and Jenny Spang. We are going to be teaching you distinguishing features of benthic macroinvertebrates. Benthic macroinvertebrates are bottom-dwelling animals without a backbone that can be seen with the naked eye. They are reliable indicators of watershed health because they are easily affected by the physical, biological, and chemical conditions of the stream. Understanding the abundance and variety of macroinvertebrates in a stream can help assess its environmental quality.
Hi, my name is Jenny Spang. Today we're sampling macroinvertebrates with a D-frame 500 micron net.
We sample multiple habitats to collect different species of macroinvertebrates. The habitats we sampled today were cobble and gravel, which is typically found in riffles, silt sand, and leaves and detritus that are found at the bottom of pools.
Now that we've collected our sample, we're going to take this back to the lab and show you how to identify these macroinvertebrates.
Hi, I'm Marissa Logan. I'm a certified taxonomist for the groups Ephemeroptera, Plecoptera, and Trichoptera, or the EPT. My certification is through Society of Freshwater Science. Let's take a closer look at the macroinvertebrates. Caddisflies comprise the order of Trichoptera. Trichoptera is the Greek for hairy wing, which refers to long hairs that cover most of the body and wings in adults. The aquatic larvae have three pairs of legs and a long, soft, segmented abdomen, which resembles that of a caterpillar. Most species have well-developed heads made of thick, hardened skin, along with chewing mouthparts. Additionally, they have a hardened plate on the thorax, which is the part of the body between the neck and the abdomen. Their antennae are very short and often not visible. Most larvae live in mobile cages constructed from stream bed materials such as plant fragments, algae, shells, and sand grains. They are held together with silk strands secreted by the larvae. Some cases are made exclusively from silk. The shape and material of the cases are distinctive of the family or group.
Mayflies belong to the Greek order Ephemeroptera. The name Ephemeroptera comes from the Greek ephemeros, meaning short-lived. This is referring to their brief adult lifespans. They can be recognized by the presence of three tails and a single claw on each leg. Additionally, they typically have leaf-like or feathery gills along their sides or near the rear portion of their abdomen. The gill shape varies among taxa. Finally, their heads are usually flattened to help them attach to rocks in fast-flowing water.
Plecoptera is derived from the Greek pleco, meaning folded, and ptera, meaning wing. This refers to their pleated hind wings, which fold under their front wings when resting. Stoneflies are easily recognized by their long filiform antenna, which is at least half the length of their body, two hooked claws at the end of each leg, wing pads present in mature larvae, an absence of gills on the sides of their abdomen, and finally, they typically have two tail filaments, or cerci. Plecoptera are the most sensitive order of aquatic insects due to their high intolerance to pollution. Along with caddisflies and mayflies, they are one of the three most commonly used indices of aquatic ecosystem health. Their presence is a reliable indicator of a high-quality stream with minimal pollution.
The order Megaloptera makes up two families, the alderflies and helgramites. Megalopterans have a hardened head and thorax and soft abdomen. The abdomen terminates into either one long tail filament or two pairs of hooks. Seven or eight pairs of lateral filaments extend from the abdomen.
Both the dragonflies and damselflies make up the order Odonata. Larval odonates are most commonly found in lentic waters. They are distinguishable by their characteristic labium or long hinged lower jaw that forms a scoop-like appendage which is used to catch prey. As larvae, dragonflies, or Anisoptera, can be distinguished from damselflies, or Zygoptera, by their stout body shape. The thorax and abdomen of dragonflies is wider than their head, while damselflies are more elongate, with a head wider than the rest of their body. Dragonfly gills are located inside the abdomen, while damselfly gills are external. Both are able to cope with low dissolved oxygen by absorbing small levels of oxygen from the air through their skin at the water's surface.
Diptera, or the true flies, have worm-like bodies with no segmented legs or wing pads. The head capsule may be obvious, reduced, or obscured. The wide diversity among this order make it difficult to outline consistent distinguishing characteristics.
Aquatic worms make up the class Oligochaeta. Oligochaetes have elongated bodies broken into many segments. They lack eye spots, suckers, legs, and antenna.
Freshwater flatworms comprise the class Turbellaria. Flatworms can be identified by their soft, elongate, flattened bodies. They also have a triangular head with two eye spots. They are primarily predators or scavengers. In healthy ecosystems, flatworms have a low to moderate presence. If the aquatic macroinvertebrate community is dominated by flatworms, this is a good indicator that the area is polluted.
Aquatic beetles belong to the order Coleoptera. Some beetles are aquatic throughout their entire life cycle, while others are only aquatic as adults or as larvae. Larval beetles have a sclerotized head, three pairs of segmented legs, and an absence of wing pads. Additionally, their entire body is typically hardened. The class Bivalvia makes up the mussels and clams. Clams and mussels have two shells or valves that are strongly connected by a hinged ligament. A foot consisting of two tubular structures can often be seen protruding from the shell. This muscle is used to open and close the valves. The inner body is made up of soft tissue and is usually pink or gray in color.
Snails make up the class Gastropoda. Operculate snails have a lid-like structure known as an operculum, which seals the body of the snail inside the shell. The shape of the shells are typically spiral.
The subphylum Crustacea includes the crayfish, which looks like a small lobster, scuds or side swimmers, which resemble shrimp, and the aquatic sow bug, which looks similar to a pill bug. Crustaceans have two pairs of antennae, a pair of mandibles, compound eyes, and two pair of maxillae on their heads, followed by a pair of appendages on each body segment.
Thanks for watching our macroinvertebrate identification video. Reach out to CEC with any questions or comments.